Your mom is on.
Oh, good.
Isn't she already have her own touch?
No, but she, I told her to listen so she knows what it's about.
Oh,
okay. This is here, my swagger mama. Yeah, yeah. Hey, babe. Bye. Thanks for hopping on, mama. Appreciate you.
Loving the music.
Liz is multitasking. She is at soccer practice. She's got a rosary in the rear view. I can see that. A rosary there hanging there. Pray for us.
Welcome, Wynn. I see you.
Hi, Dennis. Welcome.
Joseph thank looks you.
Like a Josephine.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah, Ito.
Ito's here, yes. She was our first guest, Len. Tita Josie's like a overachiever. She was here first.
Early bird credit.
Right. Hey, Coco.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Coco.
Who's the DJ tonight, Kathleen?
That would be Justin, the youngest, probably our youngest team member who has like good taste in music. So he's our guy today.
Let's get started.
Leah. All right. Welcome, everyone. Good evening. It's a beautiful day to be here with all of you and to see all of you lovely faces. My name is Leah Villaraman, and I have the absolute pleasure of being your host and MC tonight. It's so great to see so many tiles. If you can, we would love to see your face. Because then otherwise, I feel like I'm just talking to myself. And as much as I love to do that, I love to talk to other people as well. And I think we all know the Zoom etiquette already, which is to just mute yourself, which I see that all of us have done that. So high five to you. So before we get started, I want to let you know that I will be putting in the chat box a feedback form that we would love for you to go ahead and complete at any point during the webinar. So I'll go ahead and put it there. Go ahead and click on that, fill it out for us, and that way we know who attended. Now, we have an amazing webinar for you tonight. It is filled with great information. And after you hear tonight's speakers, I know you're going to leave away with some tangible ways to secure and protect yours and your family's future. Now, as most of you are aware, we are all living in some really volatile times, you know, with enormous change with all around us. What the pandemic has really revealed to a lot of us is that a lot of us were not prepared. And fortunately, we are with this company that is strategically positioned to help you and your families plan your futures, specifically your financial futures. And I am proud to announce that even during these harsh economic times, our company, Transamerica Financial Advisors, is ranked in the top 1% of all broker dealers in our country. And that is a huge deal for us. Now, I'm not saying that just to impress you, but truly just to convey how quickly our company is growing and also the tremendous business opportunities that really exist within our organization. So you're here tonight because you were invited by someone who truly cared about you. And you're here to really understand and gain some clarity on some valuable information. And that is who we are, what we do, and now also the importance of estate planning. So make sure to grab paper and pen or take notes on your phone because this is going to be a jam-packed webinar. And if you haven't done so already, please go ahead and pull up that feedback form that I put in the chat box and complete that. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the next presenters for tonight. There's two of them. And our first speaker tonight is our special guest, attorney Lorna Garcia. She's actually from the Yay area. And she has received her Juris Doctor degree from Golden Gate University School of Law back in 2005. And there she was admitted as a Dean Scholar. And prior to obtaining her law degree, she was Loma graduated magna cum laude, received dual undergraduate degrees with triple concentrations in management, economics, and finance from Notre Dame. She was accepted and graduated as a presidential scholar. She's currently one of the founding partners of Garcia & Sani LLP and a managing attorney for Intervivos Law, part of the LSPN network. Lorna previously worked as a senior litigation attorney and as an in-house counsel for several Fortune 500 companies. Now, in her free time, she loves talking to me. But Lorna actually continues to be steeped in community relations for both local and national organizations, which is one of the reasons why I truly have such a deep connection with you, with her. You know, she was twice elected as the vice president for programming and operations for the National Filipino American Lawyers Association. She's the president for the Filipino Bar Association for Northern California. She's the founder of Silicon Valley Filipino Bar Association. And she is the founder for PNAI Powerhouse, an annual women's conference focused on empowering Filipina attorneys and aspiring attorneys as a leaders in law. So that is Lorna Garcia, and she is our special guest for tonight. Right after her is our second speaker. And this person is an amazing contribution to our organization. She is also doing her main hustle of being a physician assistant for the last 20 years. She is a wife to one of our favorites, also Jason Laurel, for the next 19 years. They have three children, Abby, Josh, and Jules. And she volunteers at church and also the animal shelter, which is very close to my heart. She's been in the business with Jason now for the last 5 years. And she is, along with Jason, really one of our amazing leaders that's up and coming, not just in past, but also this year. So I want to go ahead and pass off the first speaker of tonight, which is Lorna Garcia. Lorna, go ahead and take it away.
Thank you, Leah. Everyone can see my screen here? All right. Good? Okay. Now, so nice to see everyone tonight. Thank you for joining me. I'm hoping that you walk away from tonight 10 times smarter, 100 times smarter with estate planning. Okay. Now, estate planning is so near and dear to my heart because it is very important for all of us. Like Leah mentioned, my name is Lorna Garcia. I'm the founding partner of Garcia & Sani. And I'm also one of the managing attorneys for LSPN Pro. We are an approved vendor on your platform. And so, and so what that means is we're able to help you and all of your clients in all of the 50 states, which I'm pretty excited about. Now, who needs an estate plan? All right, everybody on this call, every single one of you, every single person that you know is going to need an estate plan. Okay, now 100% of us need an estate plan, right? Let's put this into perspective. 100% of us need an estate plan. In our country, currently only 15% of us have a valid estate plan. So 85% of you out there, and I'm not going to have you raise your hand if you don't already have one. But 85% of you, 85% of your family and friends are not properly prepared, okay? And so the purpose of an estate plan is so that you can say what happens to yourself, what happens to your loved ones, and what happens to your assets. Okay, we work very, very hard all of our lives, all of these years, in order to purchase a home, to purchase a car, to make sure our kids are taken care of, right? And so we need to take that extra step to make sure that if something happens to us, that we know what's going to happen to our loved ones, what's going to happen to our assets. Now, Leah can tell me every day. We talk to each other like every day, right? And she can tell me every day what she wants to happen to her children, what she wants to happen to her home, right? But until we put that down on paper, which we are doing, until that's done, just a wish, right? The judge doesn't care what I have to say. It has to be on paper and it has to be done correctly. Now, take a look at this screen, you guys. I stole this from the great John Cordero, by the way. I don't like to take credit for him, but look at all of these people on here. And I'm not going to have you name how many you know because that's going to age you. All right. But believe it or not, every single person on this screen, think about all the money that's amassed on this page. Okay, every single person on the screen died without a valid estate plan. Okay, and so what does that tell us? That tells us that all the money in the world is not going to buy you the knowledge that you're getting here today. Okay, and so all of our friends and family, they're not going to know either until we tell them. And so, unfortunately, these people all passed Amy Winehouse, she died about more than 10 years ago, 9 years after she passed her ex-husband, mind you. So they were already divorced for 9 years, but he was still trying to get a part of her estate. Okay. And so we want to make sure that we don't end up like these people. Okay. In 2020, Kobe Bryant passed away. He did pass away with a valid estate plan. Okay. He opened up the floodgates as to what is a trust. Right? What is the will? Why is it so important? And so that's why we're here today. That's why we're here today, is because this opened up the floodgates and a lot of us started asking, why is this so important for us? So I'm so happy to see all of you on here today. Now, like I said, 85% of us don't already have an estate plan. Okay? So what happens when you don't have an estate plan? The courts are going to decide who gets your assets. Like I said, we've worked so hard for all of these assets. We want to know who's going to get them, right? So in order to know who's going to get them, we have to write it down on paper, who's going to get them. The courts are also going to decide who is the guardian of your children. Okay? I love my children so much. Sometimes more days than, you know, on some days I love them more than the other. But for the most part, if I were gone, I want them to be left with someone that shares the same values. Right? That's going to raise them the way that I wanted to raise them. And nobody knows that better than us. And so we should designate who's the guardian of our children, not some judge that's sitting on the bench, right? Not some judge that maybe is having a bad day. And so as much as we're able, we want to designate who's the guardian of our children. The courts are also going to decide who is the personal representative of your estate. What does that even mean? That means who's going to come in, who's going to come in and take a look at all of our assets and decide who's going to get them, right? Who's going to distribute them? Now, we can decide who that is. The courts are also going to decide how and when our assets are distributed. Now, some of you on here are like, I don't care. As long as my kids get them, as long as my family gets them, we're good to go. Well, some of us have young children, right? Some of us have young adult children, and we don't necessarily want those children or our, let's say, disabled children or elderly parents getting everything all at once, right? Because our young children are not going to know how to spend $500,000 in life insurance funds, right? Our younger children are not going to know how to manage our real estate properties, right? And then another thing, our elderly parents, we have all these good intentions of leaving them some stuff if something happened to us, but we forget that if they're receiving Social Security or if they're receiving Medicare and we leave them something, the government flags that as income and they lose those benefits, right? We have all good intentions, but they lose those benefits. And so we want to avoid that as much as possible. And that's why it's so important to be able to structure how our loved ones are going to get our assets. Now, here's a big one, you guys. If we don't have the proper paperwork, what happens is our estate's going to go through something called probate, right? You guys have heard that word before. Probate is a bad word. And so it's a bad word because what happens is if we don't have an estate plan, our family has to go to probate so that they can get our assets, right? And in order to do that, the court's going to freeze them. The court's going to freeze them until they figure out what's correct. How long are they going to freeze these assets? Pre-COVID, it was about 6 to 9 months. 6 to 9 months. But now, about 1.5 to 2. So that means our children, right, or our loved ones are not going to have access to our assets for at least 1.5 to 2 years. Do you think that the bank cares that your kids are not able to pay your house for 2 years because you're gone? No, they don't care that you're gone. Right? They just care about getting paid. And if our loved ones don't have access to our bank accounts or to our assets to be able to pay these bills, they get foreclosed on. So we want to make sure that it passes seamlessly. And then by passing through probate, also what I forgot to mention is it's going to cost at about an average of 4% of the value of your estate. Okay, so what does that even mean? So that means for those of us that have, let's say, $500,000, if you own a house, you're already there. You're at least $500,000, right? That means for every $500,000, our children, our loved ones, are going to have to pay out of our estate $20,000 to the court. Okay, $20,000 that we worked very hard for, $20,000 that's rightfully theirs, $20,000 that doesn't have to go to the courts. OK, Okay, so how do we avoid that? We create an escape plan, right? Like I've been saying all this time. We're gonna create an escape plan, right? I said everybody needs an escape plan. The complexity is gonna depend on each person, but typically, guys, it's gonna be these first five documents right here. The will, the trust, power of attorney, health directive, and HIPAA release. You've heard all of these terms at one point or another. You're gonna know what they are after today, okay? So the durable power of attorney, advanced medical health directive, and HIPAA release. Let's talk about those three first. I talk about those three first because they come into effect while we're still alive, right? Most of us don't go from alive to dead in 24 hours, right? We get old, we get sick. Sometimes, unfortunately, there's an accident of some sort and we become incapacitated, right? And if we're incapacitated, we can't make our own decisions, whether it be our medical decisions, whether it be our financial decisions. So who makes them for us, right? If we had none of these documents, our family would have to go to court, wait for the judge to give them the powers to do so. And it costs, I charge about $8,000 to $10,000 at least for that process. Okay, but we can avoid all that. We can avoid all that with these documents. The durable power of attorney, that's gonna allow you to list, if you become incapacitated at any time, who's gonna make your financial decisions? It's as easy as that. Power of attorney says who's gonna step in your shoes and make your financial decisions. Advanced health directive, that's your medical power of attorney. That's who's gonna make your medical decisions. Also within the medical directive, you're gonna decide, I'm on life support and the doctor says I'm not likely to come back. Do I wanna continue on that life support or no? So you're not preventing your death, but you're taking that decision away from your loved one. I don't know if any of you have been in that position, but it's a hard one to make, right? And so you're making that decision for your loved ones. And you're gonna decide who's gonna make my medical decisions for me. The HIPAA release, that's easy. That's basically whoever you list on there, they're gonna have access to talk to your doctor's catnosis, their PA, right? So, whoever we list on there is going to have access to our medical professionals, able to talk to them in case something were to happen to us. So those three documents, they're good while we're still alive, okay? Now, I'll get into the will and the trust in a second. Those of you on the call that have a business, okay, the number one killer for your business not continuing and throughout the generations is because there's no plan in place as to how it's going to continue if something were to happen to you, okay? We want to make sure that if you have a business, right, and your family is living off of the income of this business, we want to make sure it's going to continue if something happens to you. And that's going to be part of your estate plan. Like I mentioned earlier, some of you might have disabled children, you might have elderly parents, but you still want to leave them something, right? And in order to do that, we just have to put special language in there so that they don't lose their government benefit. And that's called a special needs trust. Now, let's talk about a will and a trust. I know you guys have heard both terms and people use them interchangeably, but we're gonna talk about what's actually the difference between the two, okay? So I'm gonna be very honest. They both kind of do the same thing, the wills and the trusts, okay? They both say how your assets are gonna be distributed, how your debts are gonna be paid, right? How are they gonna pay for your funeral? How are they gonna pay for whatever outstanding credit card debts you have? And who are these assets gonna go to? They both have what's called the personal representative. I mentioned earlier, it's that person that comes in, takes an inventory of everything and distributes it to your loved ones, right? In the will, it's called the executor. In the trust, it's called the trustee. Job is still the same. Now, what's the problem with the will? Because they both sound good, right? The problem with the will, with or without a will, right? The problem with the will by itself is that you're not avoiding the probate court system. You're still gonna have to go through probate. And this is what a lot of people don't know. They have wills, they think, oh, we're good to go. You're not. You're not gonna stay out of probate. All the will is, you guys, is it's a instructions for the judge when you do go to probate. So how do we get out of probate? That's with the trust. And so there's many different types of trust. Okay, I'm gonna talk about the most common one, which is called the revocable living trust. And it's common because it's revocable. People can change it however they want. This is how you're gonna be able to change whenever you want, but still retain control over all of your assets. and still avoid probate, right? It's a win-win situation. In the trust is how you're going to provide for your family, right? What I love about the trust, I have three children of my own, and they're ranging. My oldest is 20, my youngest is 5. Okay, I'm a parent forever, I know. And so, but what I love about the trust is that, yes, I'm going to leave all money for my children. So let's say that I leave $100,000 for each child. Okay, let's say $150,000. Okay, I leave $150,000 for each child. My 20-year-old, legally, he can get that money if I pass away, right? But I can tell you, I'm not giving my 19-year-old, I'm not going to give him $150,000 off the bat. I mean, he's a good kid, but does he know how to spend $150,000? Probably not, right? And so with the trust, I'm going to be able to say, hey, you know what? Yes, my son can have that money. But until he's 27, or whatever age you want, until he's 27, he's only going to be able to use that for medical expenses, tuition, educational expenses, and reasonable living expenses. Okay, so you can kind of dictate how your children should spend that money. I took it one step further and I said, at 27, he can have 20%, right? And then every couple of years, I would give him a little more so that he blew the money the first time. At least it's only a little bit, not the whole thing. I mean, it still makes me mad, but at least it's only a little bit and he'll still have another chance later on. Okay, and that's the beauty of the trust. You're able to do that there. You can make it as complex as you want to be or not, right? One of the main goals is to be able to dictate how those assets are going to be spent, as well as keeping out of probate. Okay, so that's immediate transfer to your children. So one of the questions that I get is, well, this trust sounds amazing. I want it. I don't need this will. Okay. Well, I'm gonna create it for you anyways. Two reasons. Okay, because everyone still needs a will. Number one is if you have minor children, incapacitated children, you cannot designate the guardian of your children in the trust. That has to be done through the will. So you're gonna need it anyway. Okay. Now that only applies to those of you that are parents. The second reason is gonna apply to everybody. Let's say I create your trust tomorrow. I put everything in there that you own, right? And then AG, let's see, in 3 weeks, you win the lotto. Good times, right? And it's so good that you forget to call attorney Lorna and say, hey, I need to put this $100 million in my trust, right? And then you pass away before you spend it all. So what's going to happen to AG's, let's say you have $20 million left. What's going to happen to that $20 million, right? It's not in the trust. Kind of floating around out there. What's going to happen to it? Well, the will is going to have language that says, even though AG didn't put this extra money in the trust, it's still his wish that it be distributed the same way, okay? So it'll still flow through that trust. It's almost like a safety net, you guys. It's going to catch all of those extra assets just in case you forgot. Okay. Now, that's it, ABCs. You guys know everything about estate planning now. Well, the basics of it. So those are the basics, you guys. If you want to get into, you know, into more depth and talk about what plan is best for you, go back to whoever invited you today and they will set up a free consultation for you. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. I think we're passing it on to Kat.
You are. Thank you so much, Lorna, for all that information. And thank you, Leah, for that kind introduction earlier. The respect is mutual. We are lucky to be on this journey with you. Thank you to Lorna for dropping some important knowledge and information that's valuable to all our guests today. So I have the pleasure to use the last several minutes here of our webinar to drop some knowledge of my own, give you some information about who we are, about our company and our crusade. Lorna told us about what we need to do now to protect our assets to ensure that it is properly transferred to the loved ones you leave behind after you die. But what Jason and I do, together with our team that's here, is to give you the knowledge, education, and strategies to build that wealth, protect those assets while you're still alive, so you can have something substantial to leave behind in those wills and trusts, a legacy that you can be proud of. So at this point, I'm going to share my screen. We good? Any thumbs up, Leah? Yes? All right. So to us, this is not just an estate planning webinar. It's an opportunity to significantly impact your lives and that of your family and friends. our team takes that very seriously, and we want to make sure that you are taken care of. So now that we know about a little bit about our crusade, a little, just a tad bit before I go further, I'm going to tell you about our company. Let me tell you about our company, Aegon. Aegon is based in Hague, Netherlands. It is a publicly traded company. Aegon is a Fortune Global 500 company with $500 billion assets. And we're in the top five largest insurance and retirement companies in the world. It's a multinational company, and their roots date back 175 years, and they presently do business and operate in 20 different countries. Aegon acquired Transamerica. You can see that triangular building pyramid there, that's in San Francisco. And since 2014, Aegon's various businesses were consolidated under the Transamerica brand name. As of December 2019, Transamerica has managed around $453 billion in assets, as I mentioned earlier, in revenue generating investments. One fun fact is that Transamerica supplied Walt Disney with a loan, which allowed him to complete Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. So isn't that awesome, right? So we have an amazing track record for success. Our business model allows us to build our own company, but even though we are in business for ourselves, we're definitely not doing this business alone, as you can see us collaborating with the team that's here today. We are non-captive, so that allows us to do business in all 50 states. Presently, Jason and I do business in California, Washington, Hawaii, Arizona, and Wisconsin, just to name a few. And that's just the beginning as we continue to grow our business. Transamerica Financial Advisors is our broker-dealer, and our platform is World Financial Group. We call what we do holistic financial planning. It's not just retirement, investment, insurance, it's everything in between. We talk about living trust, as you heard, and wills, as you heard from Lorna, college plans and tax planning. We put you in a situation in retirement where you're not going to be afraid to run out of money, even if you live a long life, and then still have enough wealth to leave for your family. These are the companies that are affiliated with us. We have partnerships with them, and you probably recognize their commercials: Nationwide, Pacific Life, Fidelity, Prudential, just to name a few. And you may not be sure what company is better than what, and that's what we do. That's why we're here. We help you navigate these companies. We give you a better understanding of what they do. All of them offer almost the same products: retirement plans, insurance plans, pension plans, and savings accounts. We help you understand which one of them are best for you, because we're here for you. And as Leah mentioned earlier, I am a physician assistant. And so part of my job is to examine, diagnose, and recommend a treatment plan for my patients. Those who are PAs here also know that. Ray is one, as well as Mel. So in this company, we are money doctors, and we help people from a financial standpoint by diagnosing and making recommendations to improve their financial health. So the crusade that we are all on is to better the financial futures of our clients with wealth and health protection. And to do that, we educate them about money, because unfortunately there wasn't a class taught in high school about financial literacy. So you can imagine there are so many people who need to know how to make extra money, how to save it, and how to protect that money. So together with our team, we're on a crusade to make a positive financial impact on the people around us. This crusade is founded on the mantra of no family left behind. And because there are so many that are in need, we are on a mission to talk to as many people as we can so we can help them and the ones they love. So there are six categories that we concentrate on when we sit down with families. And when we're having this heart-to-heart discussion with them, we ask them to do some self-reflection and rate themselves on a scale of 1 to 10 in these six categories, so they have a better idea of where they stand financially. The first three things have to do with building wealth, and the second three deal with protecting that wealth. So the first thing is, have you ever thought about your cash flow? Are you happy with how much you're making? And does it have the horsepower to reach your goals? If not, will it ever? But what if we were to double, triple? Wouldn't that be just mind-blowing? So is what you're doing now, does it have what it takes to reach your goals of doubling and even tripling your monthly cash flow? If not, will it ever, as I mentioned? So on a scale of 1 to 10, how is your cash flow? 1 being you're working check to check, and 10 being you've got multiple income sources to sustain your lifestyle and allows for investing. The second thing is the emergency fund. Pre-COVID, most people believe that 3 to 6 months was what was needed to get you through any rough patches. But I think that we got a reality check that this pandemic, that 3 to 6 months is in no way close to getting us through an emergency. So on a scale of 1 to 10, do you have at least 1 year in monthly, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being that you have 0 months in an emergency fund, and 10 is if you got at least 1 year or more. Third, what do you have in place for retirement? Are you on track to retire with a sufficient amount of money and at the age you want to quit your job? For most people our age, me being in my mid 40s, you'd need $4 million by the age of 65 to live on what $100,000 a year buys today. Which means if you reverse engineer those numbers, if you're technical, based on a 12% rate of return and a doubling effect of every 6 years, that means you'd need 2 million by the age of 59, 1 million by the age of 53, 500,000 by the age of 47, and 250,000 by the age of 41. Now that's if you want to retire at 65. If you actually want to retire earlier than that, you're going to have to accelerate those numbers. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being you have gotten no retirement buckets in place, and rate yourself a 10 if you're on track to retire on time and even earlier, where do you land? Now here on the right side, in terms of wealth protection, the fourth thing we help people with is life insurance. Did you know that statistics show that a little over half of Americans have life insurance? And of those, maybe less than half of them have enough coverage. So what does that mean? That means the demand for our services is overwhelming. People don't realize that buying life insurance is guaranteeing that the ones you love continue to live the life you worked so hard to provide for them. That is your last and final gift to them. So you definitely want to make sure you have enough. We can sit down with you and help you determine what's enough. So rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 10. 1 is no insurance, and a rating of 10 if you've got at least the right amount of more, right amount plus more. The fifth is terminal illness and long-term care. Should you be diagnosed, God forbid, with a terminal illness that's going to take you out in the next 12 months, would you be able to quit your job today so you could live comfortably or maybe tackle your bucket list? Or maybe have funds to help you seek alternative life-saving treatment or a clinical trial in another country? Could you finance this without tapping into your nest egg that your spouse and family may need after you die? Then there's long-term care. This is probably the biggest expense in retirement and the one that is least accounted for. People don't want to have to ever think about who's going to have to bathe them or care for them when they're too old or weak to care for themselves. But that's the reality, folks. Jason and I literally just lived that reality last year when Jason's dad passed away. We had to set up our house, get it ready for all of dad's medical and basic life needs. We had to learn how to administer meds, his food for the G-tube, literally clean him like a baby because he was no longer continent. I know for a fact that this is not the life dad wanted for him or for us. And even though he died very shortly after coming home, Jason and I were ready to put in the work to care for whatever dad needed for as long as he needed it, even if it compromised our jobs and our livelihood. Luckily, we could financially afford the money and the time to be there for dad because that's what families do. But if you don't think about it and plan for it, then you're jeopardizing burning through your retirement nest egg or leaving it up to your family to make choices on your behalf because of what they can't afford. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being you've never thought about terminal illness, long-term care, and 10 meaning you have a definite savings plan to fund these healthcare scenarios. Lastly, do you have a will or living trust? Lorna just, you know, dropped the mic on that earlier, so I don't need to go into that. She did an amazing job doing that. So rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 if you do not have a will or trust, 10 if you do, and it is updated annually. So what we do essentially is educate others on what they need to build and protect wealth during their lifetime. Surprisingly, so many people are unaware of what is available to them. And we've made it a mission, as I mentioned earlier, to make sure they know, because knowledge is power. So that's what we do to help you, your families, and your friends. We work with you to increase your net worth, protect it from unforeseen circumstances, so that you have a legacy to leave behind for the ones you love. So what's next for our valued guests here? Well, I'm going to wrap up with this. We've done a quick overview and highlight of what we do and why we do it, but please get back with the person who invited you here tonight and they can help you provide more information or answer any questions you may have. We have three options here and I'd like to know which one fits you best. Option number one, we can provide you with a free financial needs analysis. We can also connect you to Lorna and her team for a consultation on estate planning, but you got to go through us so we can help you make sure you know got what you need. That will allow us to give you an idea of where you are right now and give you a roadmap of where you want to go and how to get there. Option number two, let us provide information on any of the six categories we mentioned that I mentioned earlier of getting your financial house in order, whether it be improving your cash flow, eliminating debt, retirement strategies, life insurance and living benefits, and then of course the living benefits of long-term care, and of course the will and trust. We can get you from a rating of zero to hero with proper education and planning. Lastly, number three, if you rated yourself tens across the board on the six steps, we do have a handful of people that are awesome like that. All we kindly do is you direct us to that one person who can benefit from what you experienced here with us and maybe connect us on a three-way text. With that, I want to thank you all for joining us here this evening. Please thank the person who invited you tonight because they thought so much of you to invite you. They'll be reaching out to you in the next 24 to 48 hours to get your feedback. And of course, fill out the form. I think Leah will allude to that again. And I'm going to pass it back to her.
Thank you so much, Kat and Lorna. That was amazing information. It was obviously really important to hear all of that. And I could see people busily writing down. So I know that this has resonated with you at some point. You know, it's spring right now. So we're doing this financial housekeeping, right? What a better way to start today, tonight. And you got some really good information from Lorna and also from Kat. Now I went ahead and put the feedback form on the chat. So please go ahead and fill that out. And then you can go ahead and let us know and rate us in those six categories that Kat had mentioned. And then at some point we'll be able to go ahead and connect you with Lorna so that we can go ahead and get you protected and secured for your generational wealth. So I'd like to thank all the guests who came out tonight to show support. And as you can see, we're all like-minded, business-oriented professionals, all really seeking to make that lasting impact in our lives and as well as yours. So thank you so much for coming. The people and the person that invited you tonight sought you out for a particular reason, and I really want to challenge you to see those exact same qualities and potential that they see in you, and then have a heart-to-heart conversation and discussion on how we can work together and to get your stars aligned to make that change that you've been waiting for, along with the services that we offer. So that wraps up tonight's business presentation. Again, please fill out that form on the chat box. And now we're going to go ahead and have some amazing training for all our associates. So for those of you that were invited, please go ahead and log off if you can. And within the next few minutes, after you've gotten the feedback form right there in the chat. And then otherwise, you know, thank you again for your time. We hope you have a blessed evening and hope to see and hear from you soon. Feel free, and everybody else, hop back on in about 30 seconds.
Thanks, Dad.
Demopolis is in the house. What's up, Keanu Reeves?
Not no more.
What's up? Not no more. You got cut your Samson here. Hey, hon, you're late, babe. I just finished.
I know. John just told me, and I had a work meeting, so I just.
I understand. It's good to see you. Happy belated birthday, by the way.
Thanks.
I'm sure they'll connect with you as well. I think John is talking, but his mic is off, so I'm not sure if he's going to say something. But
yeah, I was singing happy birthday, but darn.
Oh, you missed
it. No worries. All right,
Chris, thanks for hopping. We'll catch you at the next. Fair?
Yep.
Awesome. I'll hit you up, Chris. All right.
See you. Talk to the crew. Yep. Talk to the family. Bye.
See ya.
Love the people.
Filipino time. You know, he got the reminder like now is what he got. He got John's reminder like a second ago.
Good job, everyone. That was an amazing turnout. Allison.
Is Allison team?
Yeah, Allison is part of the team.
Yay! Welcome.
There she is. Yay!
Morning. There we go. Smiling faces.
All right. Nice.
Yeah, she's brand new. So I know, Allison, you and I have not done our one-on-one yet. So it might be a little overwhelming, but at the same time, you can stay on for just a little bit because Lorna, now I'm going to bring up Lorna. She did an amazing job. Did she? Always. I
love it again.
Every single time I talk to you, Lorna.
Well done.
And hear you speak. So you killed it. Thank you so much for that. And I already had some texts saying that they want to schedule an appointment. So this is the amazing part of the business is that we're able to have these associations and be affiliated with the top-notch professionals out there, including people like Lorna. And she has her own business. And you know, you heard all the accolades that I already had for her. It's a lot. Like, it's a long, long list of accolades for Lorna. But outside of that, She is a pretty amazing person. I can attest to it. She's really funny. But she's here now to do the other part of the presentation, which is mostly from the agent standpoint, right? Like, how does this work for us? And how are we able to maneuver